We can make primary, secondary amines. What if we need to make a tertiary amine? Well, to make a tertiary amine, we're going to start with a secondary amine. And that's how we're going to build up to our tertiary amine. Just as with secondary amines, we're going to have two methods to make our tertiary amines. And our first one is going to start with an enamine. For the secondary amines, one method started with an amine. Now we're going to have an enamine. So to make an enamine, we need to start with a secondary amine. And we shall treat this with a carbonyl compound. And we'll perform this in an alcohol solvent like methanol. And we get our enamine. Oops. And if you remember, when we wanted to make secondary amines and we made our amine, we then treated that with sodium borohydride. Well, as it turns out, we can treat enamines with sodium borohydride also. And again, we'll use an alcohol solvent. You know, probably ethanol is the preferred solvent, but you can use methanol. I think this is a little bit surprising because you think, man, you can't use these hydride reagents to reduce a carbon-carbon double bond. But that, in fact, is exactly what we're going to do to make our tertiary amine. We're going to reduce that carbon-carbon double bond. As it turns out, in this reaction, what happens? I'm not going to draw a full structure. But in the presence of methanol, you get a little bit of this going on. The enamine can attack and form a little bit of an aminium ion. And once that aminium ion forms, the hydride says, aha, I will attack you. So we're not in the reaction, we're actually forming a carbon nitrogen bond, which gets reduced. That's a detail, may or may not be interesting, but that's what happens. And that's why we're able to reduce enamines with sodium borohydride to make tertiary amines. Okay, what's our second method? We can also use the amide chemistry that we saw with secondary amines. So here is our secondary amine. We can treat this with an acid chloride, and we'll do this in strong base. Often it is sodium hydroxide, and we will make an amide, simply converting one acid derivative of the acid chloride to a new acid derivative. And just as we saw with secondary amines, we can treat our amide with lithium aluminum hydride and water. And we will make a new tertiary amine. It's drawn a little bit differently, but it is the exact same as the tertiary amine in the first pathway, the enamine pathway. This enamine pathway, just as the amine pathway was called, this is called a reductive amination. I would argue that the bottom pathway, the amide route, is also a reductive amination. But when people say reductive amination, they are typically talking about using amine or enamine chemistry, such as what we've shown here on this top of the slide, to alkylate amines. Alkylate meaning add an alkyl group, going at the very top, going from a secondary to a tertiary amine.